for reading and English. I said that backwards, but that's okay. You get the idea. We're very happy to have him join us, and so here's Mr. Payne.
Good morning, everybody. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Put on your thinking caps, buckle up your seat belts, and hold on tight. I want you to know how proud I am that you guys have read over 1,600 books to prepare for that. Isn't that awesome? That is great. Good job. That's terrific. Thank you to Liberty High School also for hosting this event. We're very happy to be here today, and we're glad that Highland made it. Yay, we were waiting for you guys. Good to see you. Just a couple of instructions before we get started. Before the questioning begins, I'm going to ask the students at each table. We'll start with Highland School and go around. Tell us your name so that you get practice with the microphone, and also what your favorite book is. So if you all would start your name and your favorite book.
Me?
Each person at your table.
My name is Leah. And my favorite book is A Handful of Stars.
My name is Diego, and my favorite book is The Island Dr. Libris.
My name is Ever, and my favorite book is Elvis and the Underdogs.
Very good.
My name is Donovan, and my favorite book is Island Dr. Libris.
My name is Chloe, and my favorite book is The Island of Dr. Libris.
Grace Miller.
My name is Aiden Kretz, and my favorite book is Nuts to You.
My name is Kayla Moyer, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Aiden Nydick, and my favorite book is The One and Only Ivan.
My name is Sarah Ward, and my favorite book is Dash.
My name is Briar Lane, and my favorite book is Dash.
I'm Peyton Meadows. My favorite book is The Island of Dr. Libris.
Hi, my name is Ashley Reed. My favorite book is The Dark Stairs.
My name is Adriana, and my favorite book is A Handful of Stars.
I'm Warren, and my favorite book is Elvis and the Underdogs.
I'm Matthew, and my favorite book is Archer's Quest.
I'm McKenna, and my favorite book is Detective's Assistant.
My name is Ashley, and my favorite book is Nuts to You.
My name is Nick, and my favorite book is The Turtle of Oman.
My name is Liliana, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Shelby, and my favorite book is Crash.
My name is Mandy, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Jacob, and I like Elvis and the Underdogs.
My name is Jack Wargo, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Luke, and my favorite book is A Handful of Stars.
My name is Juliana, and my favorite book was Dash.
I'm in trouble with that mic.
My name is Charles, and I like Nuts to You.
My name is Grace, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Tyler, and my favorite book is Island of Dr. Libris.
My name is Lane, and my favorite book is Running Out of Time.
My name is Allie, and my favorite book is Nuts to You.
My name is Kelby, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Marcella, and my favorite book is Detective's Assistant.
My name is Georgia.
My name is Georgia. My favorite book is Cosmic.
My name is Elizabeth, and my favorite book is The Island of Dr. Labrie.
My name is Emily,
favorite book is Dash.
My name's Amanda, and my favorite book is Dash.
My name is Darcy, and my favorite book is Crash.
My name is Ethan. My favorite book is Archer's Quest.
My name's Diana, and my favorite book is Detective's Assistant.
My name is Judith, and my favorite book is The Dark Stairs.
My name is Callan, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Riley, and my favorite book is A Handful of Stars.
My name is Isabella, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Delaney, and my favorite book is Dash.
My name is Savannah, and my favorite book is Penny from Heaven.
My name is Rahatha, and my favorite book is Cosmic.
My name is Sam, and my favorite book is A Long Way from Chicago.
My name is Sammy, and my favorite book is Cosmic.
My name is Owen, and my favorite book was Cosmic.
My name is Jake, and my favorite book was Running Out of Time.
My name is Ruth. My favorite book is Running Out of Time.
My name is Kate, and my favorite book was also Running Out of Time.
My name is Lily, and my favorite book is Cosmic.
My name is Griffin, and my favorite book was Running Out of Time.
My name is Wyatt, and my favorite book was Elijah of Buxton.
My name is Gabriel, and my favorite book is Elijah of Buxton.
Hi, I'm Carson, and my favorite book was Night of the Twisters.
My name is Jacob, and my favorite book was The Turtle of Oman.
I'm Ryan, and my favorite book was The 100-Year-Old Secret.
I'm Gabe, and my favorite book was The Turtle of Oman.
I'm Trent, my favorite book was Cosmic.
I'm Randy, and my favorite book was Inside Out and Back Again.
All right. Thank you all for your patience. We weren't able to set up last night as we were accustomed to, so it's good that we did that check, and thank you all for getting set up this morning so quickly. These are the rules. Listen carefully. There will be 12 rounds. The first six rounds will be written answers, and the last six rounds will be oral answers. For the first six rounds, each team will receive an envelope with the same question at the beginning of each round. The moderator will read the question aloud once. The teams will have 45 seconds in which to write their answer to the question. At the end of 45 seconds, the moderator will say, "Time is up, please show your answers." The teams will hold up their answers. The judges will determine if the answers are correct. So please write carefully, and we're also going to ask the captains to read your answer for us. We learned that from last year. If you'll read your answer aloud to us, that will help us. For the last six rounds, each team will be asked one question per round. The team will have 30 seconds in which to answer the question. At the end of 30 seconds, the moderator will say, "Time is up, we need an answer." The team captain is authorized to give the answer following consultation with team members. The answer must be given immediately to be accepted. During the last six rounds, the team captain may ask the moderator to repeat the question one time. Each school has the chance to have two out of their six questions repeated. The stopwatch will be stopped while the question is repeated and then restarted. The team will be given a total of 30 seconds to give the correct answer. To be considered correct, the full title of the book must be provided. Subtitles are not required. The author of the book is not required. If an answer differs from the answer on the moderator's question and answer sheet, the judges will determine if the answer given is correct. If a question is missed, it will not be passed on to the next team. Each team will receive a new question. 1 point will be given for each correct answer. Partial points will not be awarded. If there is a tie at the end of 12 rounds, there will be up to 3 tie-breaking rounds. Each team will be given the same question and answers. Each team will be given the same question and answers will be written. The team will have 1 minute in which to write the answer to the question. A team is immediately eliminated during the tie-breaking round if it does not give the correct answer. If after 3 rounds the tie is not broken, a tie will be declared. The audience is asked to please hold applause until after each round. The score will be announced after round 6, round 12, and if necessary, after any tie-breaking rounds. Good sportsmanship is expected by all. It is not appropriate to cheer when a team gives an incorrect answer. A traveling plaque will be engraved with the name of the winning school and housed at that school until the final meet the following year. Okay, we're going to start off with question one, the blue question. Remember to write carefully, and captains, please read your response when we ask you to do so. Here's the question. In which book did a character once wear a daisy costume and sing, "I'm a daisy born in the spring, I burst from the ground when the birdies sing"? Okay, time's up. Does everyone raise their hands? Okay, you can raise your sheet up and captains, read off your answers for me, starting over here.
The 100-year-old secret.
The 100-year-old secret.
The 100-year-old secret.
That's to you.
The 100-year-old secret.
A handful of stars.
Inside out and back again.
The 100-year-old secret.
The 100-year-old secret is correct. Question number two, the yellow question. In which book would you read the following? It turns out being a dad is a competitive sport. Okay, time is up. Let's see your answers. We'll start over here. Read your answer to us.
Cosmic.
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 Everybody got that one right. Very good. Question number three. This is the orange question. In what book would you read the following quote? I like colorful tales with black beginnings and stormy middles and cloudless blue sky endings. Okay, time is up. I've been asked by the judges to announce the correct answer before you read your answer. The correct answer is the one and only Ivan. Let's see your responses.
The island of Dr. Libris.
The total of Oman.
The one and only Ivan.
A handful of stars.
The one and only Ivan.
The one and only Ivan.
The one and only
Inside Out and Back Again.
Island of Dr. Libris.
The one and only Ivan.
What's the last one?
The one and only Ivan.
Did you all need to hear any of those again?
Penny from Heaven.
Any others? We good? Yes? Highland, what was your answer?
A Long Way from Chicago.
Okay, thank you. The judges really need to hear your answer because they're marking it. So speak very clearly and make sure if your mic isn't working that we wait to hear. Question number four. We're going to have to go a little bit slower because we have to mute each mic and then turn it back on. So pause for just a slight bit before you tell us your answer, okay? In what book would you read the following description? The bed was a big mess and there were clothes and shoes all over the place, but this was not the room of a kid who vegged out in front of video games or sat around watching Nick at Night reruns all the time. Okay, time is up. Remember, slow down just a little bit. The correct and also keep your posters up for a little longer after you say the correct answer. The correct answer is the map trap. Hold your posters up high and please read your answer.
The island of Dr. Libris.
The map trap.
The map trap.
Slow down just a little bit. Okay. Go ahead.
The map trap.
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 Running out of time.
Crash.
Crash. The map trap.
The map trap.
Okay. Judges, hear all those? Okay, thank you. The next question. Question number five is the green question. In which book does a character explain, because I was not put on this earth to spend my days filing a man's papers, or writing down every word he utters, nor washing trousers and darning his socks? Because I can do most any job a man can do, and maybe even do it better. Okay, time is up. Hold your answers up high and give us your answers slowly, please. The correct answer is the detective's assistant.
Yes.
So say your answer for us.
The detective's assistant.
Hold up your paper so we can see it. Okay.
The detective's assistant.
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 Penny from Heaven.
The detective's assistant.
The detective's assistant.
The detective's assistant.
The detective's assistant.
Okay, thank you all. Next one. This is question 6, the pink question. In which book is the following? Let us wish the boy continued good fortune on his journey. May his flights of fancy lead us all to the financial rewards we so richly deserve. Okay, time is up. Let's see your answers. Please hold them up high. The correct answer is The Island of Dr. Libris. Would you all read your answer to us?
The Detective's Assistant.
The Turtle of Oman.
The Island Elijah. Of the
Slow
Island
down just
of Dr. Libris.
Good.
Elijah of Buxton.
The Island of Dr. Libris.
A Long Way from Chicago.
The Island of Dr. Libri.
The Island of Dr. Libris.
A Long Way from Chicago.
Elijah of Buxton.
The Island of Dr. Libris.
The Island of Dr. Libris.
The Island of Dr. Libris.
Okay, thank you. So I believe that was the last question. That's the end of round 6. Let's give everybody a big round of applause. So for the last 6 rounds, each team will be asked one question per round, and you'll have 30 seconds in which to answer the question. At the end of the 30 seconds, I'll say time is up, we need an answer, and the team captain is the authorized person to give the answer following consultation with your team members, and the answer must be given immediately to be accepted. Okay, we're going to announce the score after round 6. So let's hold off for 1 second until the judges are ready. Just a reminder, boys and girls, to be considered correct, the full title of the book must be provided. And if a question is missed, rather than repeat the question for the next group, you get a brand new question, okay? Okay, here are the scores so far. Highland 3, Grace Miller 4, Pearson 5, Pierce 5, Ritchie 5, Smith 5, Thompson 6, Wakefield 6, Walter 1, Bradley 3, Brumfield 3, Coleman 4, and Greenville 6. Okay. Okay, Highland, are you ready for your question? Are we ready, judges? In which book does a man call a family's house a bridge to the sea? Okay, time is up. What is your answer, Captain?
The detective's assistant.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. It's Inside Out and Back Again. Miller, your question. In which book is a Ferris wheel described this way? The wind rocked the painted seats, but the wheel itself was completely still. It looked as if it was leaning away from the commotion, embarrassed by what was going on below.
Dash?
That is the correct answer. Are we going to allow them to answer immediately if they can, or do we want to wait the 30? Is that okay? Okay. Just want to caution you, make sure you've got the right answer that you've consulted with your group. Might be a good idea since you get 30 seconds if you need it. All right, Pearson, in which book do you find this quote? What I don't love, pink sofas, green chairs, plastic covers on a table, stained mattresses, old clothes, unmatched dishes.
Inside Out and Back Again.
Inside Out and Back Again is correct. Very good. Okay, Pierce, your question. In which book did a character serve applesauce, plums, cherries, and lukewarm stewed tomatoes?
Could you please repeat the question?
Yes. In which book did a character serve applesauce, plums, cherries, and lukewarm stewed tomatoes?
I think it's Fauquier Stars. I think it's Fauquier Stars. I think it's Fauquier Stars.
Is it Inside Out and Back Again?
I'm sorry, it's Night of the Twisters. Okay, Richie. In which book would you read the following? It means peace in Latin, he explained. It's kind of old-fashioned, but it's a way of asking if we can stop quarreling. Okay, your answer, please.
Elvis and the Underdogs.
I'm sorry, the correct answer is The 100-Year-Old Secret. Smith, in which book is a doodle of a dragon important in the story?
The 100-Year-Old Secret.
That is correct. Thompson, your question. In which book would you read the following? They wore bright green jerseys bearing the image of two scaly sea serpents, one blue, one yellow, battling on top of a gray shield.
The 100-Year-Old Secret.
That's correct. Wakefield. In which book would you read the following? Why wasn't I worried? Because I knew he would come back for me. I never thought for a minute he wouldn't. When you're a kid, you think your dad can do anything.
Cosmic?
Cosmic is correct. Walter, in what book did a character disobey one of his parents' Ten Commandments? The one that stated, "Thou shalt not eat anything offered to you by a stranger."
Penny from Heaven.
I'm sorry, the correct answer is Elvis and the Underdogs. What is the next school's name?
Bradley.
Bradley? Okay. Bradley, in what book did a character finger her many chins when she was deep in thought?
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. In what book did a character finger her many chins when she was deep in thought?
A Long Way from Chicago.
That is correct, just in time. Brumfield, in which book would a boy rather clean stables and dig ditches than spend the day at church?
Elijah Buxton.
That is correct. Coleman, in which book must you mind your grammar even in times of distress?
Detective's Assistant.
That is correct. And Greenville, in which book would you read the following? Food was supposed to be limp at this point. This food was not limp, and when it started speaking, it gave him the heebie-jeebies.
Can you please repeat the question?
I can. In which book would you read, food was supposed to be limp at this point. This food was not limp, and when it started speaking, it gave him the heebie-jeebies. Time's up. What's your answer?
The Map Trap.
I'm sorry. It's Nuts to You. That's the end of the first round in the second half. Good job. Highland, in which book is a character given a triangular white stone with crooked lines engraved across its surface that looks like a map of the run he just took?
Can you please repeat the question?
Yes. In which book is a character given a triangular white stone with crooked lines engraved across its surface that looks like a map of the run he just took? Okay, what is your answer?
The Map Trap.
I'm sorry, the correct answer is The Turtle of Oman. Miller, in which book did someone buy a pair of, quote, bright red high-heeled shoes with glitter all over and a red bow in front, end quote, as a last-minute Christmas gift?
Crash.
The correct answer is Crash. Pearson. In which book is someone described this way? He wasn't a very good criminal. When he robbed the store, he also took a bunch of candy bars. He ate the candy and threw the wrappers out of his car window as he made his getaway. So the police just followed the trail of candy bar wrappers and caught him.
Penny from Heaven?
That's correct, Penny from Heaven. Pierce. In which book does a character hide underneath a stagecoach?
Running Out of Time?
That is correct. Richie. In which book did someone make a birthday wish that the whole family would find seats and sit together for breakfast, and it came true?
Dash.
Dash is correct. Smith, in which book do two friends find important clues to an old mystery on microfilm at the public library?
The 100-Year-Old Secret.
I'm sorry, the answer is The Dark Stairs. Thompson, in which book does a bully develop a serious crush on a girl who's too good to be true?
The Island of Dr. Labrie.
That's true, yes. Wakefield. In which book is the following quote? On the wall behind the chair, in a narrow space between the bookcases, hung a Wizard of Oz cuckoo clock with its chained pine cone weights lying sideways on the floor. Its hands stood frozen at 7 and 12.
The Island of Dr. Libris.
That is also correct. Walter, in what book does the main character's hair begin to frizz when she senses danger and adventure?
The Dark Stairs.
The Dark Stairs is correct. Bradley, in which book would you read the following? It's like a stud finder, but instead it locates metal. It's supposed to be extremely sensitive. Okay, time?
The Detective's Assistant.
I'm sorry, it's The 100-Year-Old Secret. Brumfield. In which book is a character embarrassed to invite friends to her house because a pooping dog and a burping grandfather is there?
Penny from Heaven.
That is correct. I want to read that one. Coleman, in which book would you read the following? Good morning, scholars, strivers, and questers for a better future.
Okay.
Turtle of Oman.
I'm sorry, it's Elijah of Buxton. Greenville. In which book does a girl say this? People want us to come and work, but they want us to be invisible.
Elijah of Buxton.
I'm sorry, it's A Handful of Stars. It's the end of the second round. Okay, Highland. In which book did a boy have river mud that was said to heal whatever was wrong with someone?
Crash
is correct. I told you. Miller, in which book would you read the following? In fact, we used to call it our bed boat. It was a place where you say things out loud that you might only think anywhere else.
Could you repeat the question?
In which book would you read the following? In fact, we used to call it our bed boat. It was a place where you say things out loud that you might only think anywhere else.
Crash.
That is also Crash. Good. Pearson. In which book would you read the following? She could smell his breath and she stepped back. It wasn't bad breath, the kind that can be changed by a couple of breath mints. This was 2 million-year-old breath.
The Dark Stairs.
The Dark Stairs, good. Pierce. In which book does a character have birthday cinnamon rolls instead of a cake?
Dash?
That's correct. Richie. In which book would you find the following passage? I look in her eyes and I suddenly know why she wears black. It's her way of looking fierce, of hiding the fact that she's old and tired and homesick.
Penny from Heaven.
Penny from Heaven, yes. Smith. In which book does the wearing of glasses create a think cocoon for one character and nausea for another?
The Dark Stairs.
That is correct. Thompson. In what book does a family burn all but 10 of their photographs rather than leave them behind?
Inside Out and Back Again.
That is correct. Wakefield. In which book does a character collect prayer cards from funerals?
Penny from Heaven.
That is correct. Walter. In which book would this passage be found? A good story makes a journey go by more quickly. A really good story makes you forget you're even on a journey.
Could you repeat the question?
A good story makes a journey go by more quickly. A really good story makes you forget you're even on a journey.
candy from heaven?
I'm sorry, it's nuts to you. Bradley, in which book does a character find the wearing of a blue silk brooch despicable?
The Detective's Assistant.
That is correct. Brumfield, in which book does a character have to participate in his aunt's personal fulfillment classes every summer?
Night of the Twisters?
That's correct. Coleman? In what book were there three parts to a message? A question, a threat, and a promise?
Map Trap?
That's correct. Stop. Greenville? In which book is the quote, "So there is hope, but don't be dazzled. You're definitely in a fix. Pay attention. Use your knowledge of the enemy." Your answer, please.
Dash.
I'm sorry, it's nuts to you. That's the end of the third round of the second half. Highland, in which book did someone find out that a person had agoraphobia, which is a fear of open spaces?
The 100-year-old secret?
That's correct.
Oh, yeah.
Miller? In which book does a character prefer to wear sandals walking in mud?
Dash.
Correct. Pearson? In which book would you read this? "Yes, I was getting a little worried. Did you know that? Could you tell? I tried to hide it. I thought we might have to sleep in the Jeep. And that's not a good sleep. Jeep sleep."
The Total of Oman.
That's correct. Pierce. In which book would you read the following? "It's a toy Indian kids used to make for crying out loud. That thing is authentic."
Night of the Twisters?
That's correct. Pierce. Richie, I'm sorry. That was Pierce. Name the book in which a boy receives this advice: "Never trust an ugly woman. She's got a grudge against the world."
A Long Way from Chicago.
A Long Way from Chicago is correct. Smith. In which book does a boy get drunk on something he's told is plum juice?
Cosmic?
That's correct. Thompson. In which book does a character hope that making special handmade valentines will win her friends back?
Dash.
That's correct. Wakefield, in what book would you read this? The rumbling was closer now. It was a sound, and it was also a vibration. It was like thunder, except it didn't start and stop. It just kept going.
Nuts to You?
That's correct. Walter, in which book would you read this? There she was, curled up on an old sofa with only her mouse nest hair sticking out above the blanket. She wasn't dead. She was asleep and snoring for all she was worth.
A Long Way from Chicago.
I'm sorry, it's The Night of the Twisters. Bradley, in which book would you find the following items? A red inhaler, life jackets, an old-fashioned key, and blueberry pie.
A Long Way from Chicago.
I'm sorry, it's The Island of Dr. Libris. Brumfield, in which book does a character love to wear as many petticoats at a time as possible?
The Detective's Assistant.
That is correct. Coleman, in which book does a character find himself on a wanted dead or alive poster?
The Island of Dr. Libris.
That's correct. Greenville, in which book are snacks often served in paper cones?
The Turtle of Oman.
That's correct. That's the end of the fourth round, second half. Four down. Highland, in what book did a character explain knowing everything this way? I got ears on me like an Indian scout, and I don't sleep.
Okay. A Long Way from Chicago?
Correct.
You don't have to tell me.
Miller. In which book would this passage be found? The state's not going to listen to me, but if I write a story about how a brave 13-year-old girl who risked her life for 26 children just wants to see her parents and go home.
Running out of time?
That's correct. Pearson. In which book does a character toss two treasured items into the sea?
The Turtle of Oman.
I'm sorry, it's Inside Out and Back Again. Pierce. In which book would you read, okay was a bad word no one was supposed to say, but she liked it? Sometimes she wondered if it was forbidden because it had a secret power to make things okay.
Running out of time?
That's correct. Richie, in which book would you read the following? That's the thing about parents. If you go missing, they worry that you might be dead. And then when they find you, they want to kill you.
Cosmic.
That's correct. Smith. In which book does a character have to memorize one new word a day and practice it 10 times in conversation?
Inside Out and Back Again?
Correct. Thompson? In which book would you read the following description of a character who preferred a dumpster diving lifestyle? He lives well off the ends of hot dogs he pulls from the trash. For dessert, he laps up spilled lemonade and splattered ice cream cones.
The One and Only Ivan.
That's correct. Wakefield. In which book does a character drive a police cruiser because the officer was injured?
Night of the Twisters.
That is correct. Walter. In which book would this passage be found? I don't know many kids who've lost somebody really important to them. Usually I'm the only one. It felt good to meet someone who knew that who knew that missing feeling too. Your answer, please.
The detective's assistant.
I'm sorry, it's A Handful of Stars. Bradley, in which book is the following quote? Lilies are proud and sassy. They don't know their weeds.
A Handful of Stars.
That's correct. Brumfield, in what book do you find this quote? When I was little, I thought you and Pa knew everything, and you could protect me from everything. And now it's not like that. Answer, please.
The Turtle of Oman.
I'm sorry, it's Running Out of Time. Coleman. In which book was a boy sent to Little Star's drama group to make real friends and work on his poor social skills?
Cosmic.
That's correct. In Greenville. In what book did a character prefer to eat with his back to the wall? Okay, I need your answer.
A Handful of Stars.
I'm sorry, it's Archer's Quest. That's the end of the fifth round, second half. Okay, Highland. In which book does a boy go to a carnival of oddities?
Elijah Buxton.
That's correct. Miller, in which book would you read this quote? A book club isn't about the book. It's about women getting together to talk about our lives with an assortment of baked goods nearby.
Night of the Twisters.
I'm sorry, it's Elvis and the Underdogs. Pearson. In which book do characters get in trouble when they're caught listening to a private tape-recorded conversation?
The Dark Tales.
That's correct. Pierce. In which book would you read this passage? One of my neighbors plays baseball, although she is a chicken. Another drives a fire truck, although he is a rabbit.
The one and only Ivan.
That's correct. Richie. In which book would you find the following passage? Maybe he could make a little space for bravery inside his fear. Maybe just a little. Maybe it would grow. Maybe sleeping on a roof had done something to him.
The Turtle of Oman.
That's correct. Smith. In which book would you read the following? Believe some to none of what you hear and only half of what you see.
I don't know.
May you please repeat the question?
Is that the third repeat for them? Okay. Yes. In which book would you read the following? Believe some to none of what you hear and only half of what you see.
Running out of time?
I'm sorry, it's Elijah of Buxton. Thompson. In which book does a character take off his shoes in class and another fills them with mustard?
Crash.
Correct. Wakefield. In which book does a character describe being restless and sad? She felt like she was in one long game of freeze tag. She had been tagged and nothing could unfreeze her.
Dash.
Dash is correct. Walter. In which book would you read, a good story can make a journey go by more quickly. A really good story makes you forget you're even on a journey. I think we had that question already. Sorry. Let's have another question. Recognize that one. In which book does someone describe a relative that they have just met? Her face was average looking, though it could have been pretty if it weren't lined with so much crankiness. So pinched and prim like she was, I could tell she was on the fast road to becoming a dowdy old matron.
Detective's assistant?
That's correct. Bradley? In which book is this quote? Bullies pick on me all the time, but I've never, you know, defeated one.
Elvis and the Underdogs?
I'm sorry, it's the Island of Dr. Libris. This would be Brumfield. In which book would this passage be found? That's what disasters do sometimes. They throw us together with those who are our adversaries, who play for a different team. For a short time, a common enemy dissolves our differences and makes us realize what we share until someone gets hungry.
Can you please repeat the question?
Yes. In which book would this passage be found? That's what disasters do sometimes. They throw us together with those who are our adversaries, who play for a different team. For a short time, a common enemy dissolves our differences and makes us realize what we share until someone gets hungry.
Nuts to you.
That's correct. Coleman. In which book does a character tape a welcome note inside a closet?
Turtle of Oman?
That's correct. Greenville. In which book would you read the following? You're eating meat. Oysters aren't meat. They're not vegetables. They're not fruit. Ha, oysters don't have faces.
Crash.
Crash is correct. I believe that's the end of the second half, right? Good job. I think we're going to tally the scores here. We have a tie. Here are the scores. Highland 7, Miller 9, Pearson 10, Pierce 10, Ritchie 10, Smith 9, Thompson 12, Wakefield 12, Walter 3, Bradley 6, Brumfield 8, Coleman 9, and Greenville 8. So it's tied between Thompson and Wakefield. So we need a tiebreaker. So here is the rule for a tie. If there is a tie at the end of 12 rounds, there will be up to 3 tie-breaking rounds. Each team will be given the same question and answers will be written. The team will have 1 minute in which to write the answer to the question. A team is immediately eliminated during the tie-breaking round if it does not give the correct answer. If after 3 rounds the tie is not broken, a tie will be declared. Okay? So here goes. You got your paper and your pens? Okay. Remember, you're both getting the same question and writing the answer. Name 2 books in which there are a lot of cameras monitoring people. looks like both teams are ready. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. So the correct answer is, the correct answers are Running Out of Time and The Island of Dr. Libris. Would you read what you have on your posters for me?
The Island of Dr. Libris and Running Out of Time.
The Island of Dr. Libris and Running Out of Time.
Okay. Next round. Okay, judges, this one's going to be tricky. Name three books in which old photographs are significant. Name three books in which old photographs are significant. Okay, it's time for your answers. Here are your the possible correct choices. Dash, The Detective. Time was up, folks. Just stop writing. Okay. So hold up your poster. There you go. Here are the possible correct answers. Dash, and we're going to have you read yours really slowly in a minute. The Detective's Assistant, A Handful of Stars, Inside Out and Back Again, The 100-Year-Old Secret, and Running Out of Time. So would Thompson read your answers for us?
Inside Out and Back Again,
yes.
The Detective's Assistant, and
yes.
The Dark Stairs.
And The Dark Stairs is not one, sorry. Wakefield?
The 100-Year-Old Secret.
Yes.
Inside Out and Back Again.
Yes.
Penny from Heaven.
I'm sorry, that is not correct. Next round. That was a tough one. Thank you to the remaining groups, too, for your patience and being quiet. We appreciate that. In which two books does a character remember every detail? Ready? Both groups ready? Let's put your posters up high. The two correct answers are Elvis and the Underdogs and The 100-Year-Old Secret.
Yes.
Could you read your answers to us so we can see them?
Elvis and the Underdogs and The 100-Year-Old Secret.
Elvis and the Underdogs and The 100-Year-Old Secret.
I believe we have a tie. Great job, everybody. The judges agreed that we have a tie this year. Okay. I want to thank everybody, students and teachers who supported the teachers, and especially parents and community members and family who are here for support. Fauquier County Public Schools, thanks you sincerely. And we look forward to seeing you back here next year, some of you. Thank you.